Hi, I'm Orla. I'm here at Phonica. Let's go record shopping. I wouldn't tend to categorise my sound in terms of genre, usually. I would just go by moods. So I guess on that note, we can start anywhere here. Oh, this is a great record. Maximum Joy, Stretch, from the 80s, early 80s, I believe. And this band are from Bristol, but they would tend to get grouped in with like New York post-punk. Both are really good. I would put this in like my dinner playlist. Silent Street, Silent Dub, and then Stretch is like a lot more intense. That's a like screamy vocals. Yeah, great record. My process for finding music these days is mainly like going down like internet rabbit holes, but it's usually like the older stuff that I would buy on vinyl. I know I'm gonna pick this one on Nous Clair, which is a label from Rotterdam, and it is John Talabot's alias Coral. I haven't heard it, but I know like, well, I feel like it's gonna be decent from being on this label, so yeah, I'll play this one. Yeah, Neon Vinyls, new Fabric Presents compilation, which I actually have a track on. An amazing mix with like a lot of original music in it. Yeah, recommend this one, so. I'll choose this. If I can remember correctly, one of the first records I bought was one from Ovum, which is Josh Wink's label. And it was just like a really drummy track in the same store. It was actually an Oxfam. I was just looking for like drummy stuff that I could learn to beat match with. So I remember I found one on Crosstime Rebels, can't remember the name, but I just spent hours playing those two records over and over again to just try and like match the speed of them. And it worked in the end, I guess. And that was in Liverpool, around like 2013, 2012. There's one here by Carlton Doom, who is a Belfast born and raised producer and a friend of mine, and it's called Bin Men, Machines and Sex and More, and it's on Lobster Theremin. I feel like I owe a lot to Lobster Theremin actually for just how fundamental they were in my early days of producing, in the sense that their like DIY mentality kind of encouraged me to be more free with my own productions. And also my first label, Deep Sea Frequency, was under their distribution service. Massive respect for Lobster Theremin. So I know Chris Carlton Doom from home. He's from Belfast and I'm from Derry, where I lived for I lived in Derry until like 2012, and then I went to university in Liverpool, and then stayed there for about 6 years. Enjoyed the scene there a lot. And then from there went to Berlin, lived for a couple of years, and then now I'm in London, so. Oh, this is actually one released on my own label by Blue Terra, Merrymount. And it's on my label, Céad. It was the second ever release. And Blue Terra is from Poland, and they are like an anonymous project. Oh, love this record by Charisma. Check this out. I've played this in a lot of my sets. I remember playing it in Phonox like 4 or 5 years ago. It sounds really good, like on the dance floor. Actually, on that note about Phonox, I have a residency coming up there. So just plug that. It's really handy because I live in Brixton as well. So it's like 5 minute walk from where I live. Oh, I know this one. It's actually a white label, but I know it because of this artwork. And it is the Luca Lozano remix of an old classic by Neil Cassiopeia. Be considered quite trancey in a way, but this remix slash edit makes it very playable for my sets. And that one's definitely always in my record box. This is the first release by Adonis, new label, and it includes tracks by Naira and Wilson Phoenix. I actually play for Adonis quite a bit in London, and really great queer party. First time I played for them was like New Year's Day, and it was really spontaneous because I was just there like partying, I guess, and I happened to have my USB in my pocket, and I ended up like closing with Amalia, and we played until like, I think it was like 10 a.m. And since then, like, they've brought me back quite a bit. So yeah, let's choose this one. I'm actually on the artwork for this release. It is by Rosa Trenzi on her own label, Tapestry of Sound. Really great EP, and they made this like real life tapestry. I'm like here next to DJ Fart in the Club, and we're like, I guess we're like fairies waiting to go on this buckaroo. So yeah, this is a great EP. Okay, I think I have enough records here, so we're going to listen to these over here on the turntables. So I've went for a mixture of old and new here. Let's start with this track by Voodoo's and Taboos called Doorway, and it's the one that I mentioned that I play quite a bit in my sets. So yeah, very groovy, very quite driving at the same time. I really like the kick on that one. And then next up is the Carlton Doom one by my friend Chris. And we're gonna play, I think, the track called Insects in the Jelly. I actually put this track in my essential mix. Yep, nice sweet garage tune there. And then we're gonna play the Adonis release. I think my pick here is the Wilson Phoenix track. Like spinning dick in the middle. Okay, so we're gonna play the second EP on my label, Céad, by Blue Terra. I'm gonna just skim through each of these tracks, but I think my favorite here is the track called 20,000. It's the one that I could slot into my sets. We'll be right back. yeah, that this track is probably my favourite from this release. And I'll just play the A side. Side is a lot faster. So the artwork on all of the releases on my label are by a guy called Patrick Sava. And he's based in London, and we work on like the concept of each different sleeve together. And all of this seemingly random pixels, all of these are actually like a binary code, so it was actually like a unique message. So we're gonna go for the Rosa Terenzi track next. The one I love here is the B1, Wasp of a Woman. And then I'm just going to skip through this just to show what else is on the EP. Final is this it's the Luca Lozano remix of this old Nail track, Cassiopeia. It's just one side, and it's kind of like classic sunrise track, I guess.